Hi everyone, my name is Prashant Gupta. The topic for this video is JavaScript setup and introduction to JavaScript. In this video, we will perform our basic JavaScript setup and then we will talk a little bit about JavaScript. So basically, to execute our JavaScript code in a browser, we need a code editor to write code. So we are going to use a VS Code or Visual Studio Code Editor to write our code. You can download this from the following link which I have given, or let me show you how you can download it directly from the browser. You have to simply type VS Code download, then click on the first link. Then you have to select your operating system. Depending upon your operating system, you can click on it. If it is Windows, then you have to download for Windows. If it is Mac, then you have to download for Mac. And same for the Linux machine. Since I am on Windows, so I'm going to download for the Windows only. It will take some time to download. It is of 75 MB. It is downloaded now. Let me open this. So to run the setup, you have to accept the agreement, then click on next, then click on next, and then you have to click on install button. I'm not going to install this thing because it needs a restart as well. The other thing is I have already downloaded this and installed it in my system. So let me cancel that. So you just need to click on install button, then it is fine. It will keep on installing, and once done, it will show a message. So I'm going to cancel it for now. Let me open my VS Code, which is already downloaded. Now this is how your home screen for Visual Studio Code will look like when you open this. So if you don't get this screen, you can click on the file button and then you will get all the options. So now we are going to create a folder with the help of open folder. If it is not here, you can click on file button and then click from there. Let me open this from here itself. You have to go in any directory. Let me create a new folder in here. I'm going to name this as JetJS Setup. And then we have created our first folder. To basically run our JavaScript, we have to create an HTML first. Like we know, the old HTML is needed for JavaScript. Before writing any code, let's go back to our PPT and see what it has. In this video, we will also learn how to link our JavaScript with the HTML. But let's do that first. Before moving forward, let's link our HTML with JavaScript. So to basically link our HTML, let me write some basic boilerplate code in here. So our boilerplate code is ready. I have used a snippet for that. Basically, to write your HTML to JavaScript code, you have to write it inside a script tag. Just like that, and basically we are going to use a separate file to write our JavaScript code. You can write your JavaScript code in the same file itself. I will show in both ways. Let me create an HTML JavaScript file here. The name could be anything which you want. The extension here will be .js. Let me create that. So it is created. Now let's write something in our HTML folder itself. We are not going to update anything in the separate file. So we have a command called console.log, which is used to print something. So we will get our things on our console. So console is basically where whatever you want to print will appear. It is like a screen. So let me show this in my browser only, then we will have much more clarity on this. Let's open this with our live server. So let me open this. Basically, console appears on the inspect elements, then on console. So as you can see, what I have written here is appearing in here as well. Let me update this. Let me minimize this first, then we will be able to see the changes. Now let me update this. So it is a live reload model because it is working with the live server. So it is working like that only. So whatever I'm going to update in here, updated will be updated on the console as well. Console is a very basic command. We will talk about a lot more commands in the future, but let's just see how we are going to link our things. Now we have seen how we can use a script, write JavaScript inside a script tag. Now let's put this JavaScript in the separate JS file or JavaScript file, and we will link that from there. Now, as of now, you cannot see any logs in here because there are not any, because we haven't linked our JavaScript file with the HTML. So let's do that. To basically link our HTML file JavaScript, we have to use the SRJ attribute which comes with the script tag. And inside that, you have to provide the address for the JavaScript file. It could be URL if it is an external file. If it is an internal, you have to provide the path. Since it is an internal file, I have provided the path, that is script.js in my case. So now you can see I'm writing things on my console. Let me change this inside the script file. So it is getting updated as well. So if you have seen how we can link our HTML file with the JavaScript and see the live changes. Now coming back to the PPT, introduction to JavaScript. Well, the first thing is, what is JavaScript? So we have already learned the HTML and CSS. HTML, if we compare HTML, CSS and JavaScript with the human body, HTML acts as like a skeleton of the body. Like it gives you a basic structure of that. Now comes the CSS part. CSS is like your styling or basically your clothing. So we have the skeleton, now you've got the clothing, muscles and all of that. But now you need a brain. Now JavaScript acts as a brain for your HTML and CSS. Consider a human being without a brain. You cannot interact with that. Same is the case with the website. If a website or a web page don't have JavaScript, you cannot interact with that. It cannot be responsive. It cannot respond to your button click. It cannot respond to your whatever text you have typed. It cannot do anything without the help of JavaScript. It is just a plain static page to which to display data. Nothing else. With the help of JavaScript, it becomes responsive and it can be used in much other use. Now, why JavaScript? Why don't we use any other languages? Like there are a lot of languages in market like Java, C++ and others. So why do we actually need JavaScript? We can use JavaScript on both front-end and back-end side. So JavaScript can work on front-end as well as server side. Front-end is our basically client side, which we see, and back-end is a server side, on which whatever input you have given, client input, whatever the client input is given, being processed and saved in the database as well, and all of that is backend. Now we can also use JavaScript libraries to develop mobile applications. Now JavaScript could also be used to develop a mobile application as well. Now, there is JavaScript library called React Native. You can use their JavaScript. That is basically built on top of JavaScript. So you can use that to build mobile applications. We can use Electron to develop desktop application. Electron is also a JavaScript framework or library which is built on top of JavaScript, which is used to develop desktop application. So we have seen we can use JavaScript to develop web pages or web applications. We can also use JavaScript also its libraries to develop mobile application. Now we can use Electron, which is also a JavaScript framework, to develop desktop applications. Now, as you can see, JavaScript can be used everywhere, in the desktop applications, in the mobile applications, in the web pages, and whatnot. JavaScript helps us to make our web page responsive. We have already talked about this. Learning curve for JavaScript is comparatively low. So when you will learn the JavaScript, you will see that it is quite easier to learn if you are going to compare it with the other languages like Java, C++, and others. It will be much easier to learn. So let's get started. In the coming up video, we will talk about JavaScript variables, how we can declare a variable, what kind of declaration we have in the JavaScript, and all of that. So thank you everyone. See you guys in the next video.